Jürgen, many congratulations. You're off to Wembley.
Thank you. Yeah, it's great. It's a while ago, so it was time, pretty much. And we are really happy about it. And the mood in the dressing room at the moment is, we are over the moon, obviously, because it was a difficult game for us. It's a difficult time, in general, that we just have to get through this. And we try everything we can to do that. And what the boys made tonight against this really strong Arsenal side was absolutely exceptional. The start in both half times, so like first half, Arsenal was really pretty lively. The crowd was there, stuff like this. Then we calmed it down, played good football, could really play in and around their formation, created not plenty, but the quality of it's not so easy. Second half was pretty similar. And again, we scored two wonderful goals, I have to say. Wow, Jota shot on fire. But the passes were, and the first goal was super play, and the second one, I don't think a lot of people in the stadium saw Diogo in that position, but Trent saw it, which was helpful. And then he finished it off absolutely outstanding.
Obviously, no Mane or Salah, so he needed to step up. And Keita, yeah, but in terms of your front three, he's really stepped up, hasn't he? How much has he progressed since he arrived at Anfield?
We were completely convinced when he arrived that he will help us massively. So many things, you know, when you watch a player before you sign him, you have nowadays the opportunity to watch 100 games if you want, and we're really comfortable. But of course, since he's here again, he made another step, and it's absolutely helpful. It's just he turned into a world-class striker meanwhile, and that's how's that for us, pretty helpful.
You enjoyed that VAR decision, didn't you? You celebrated wildly.
Yeah, after, but it was like, it was really close, obviously. So for me, it was no offside, but when it's whistled and it's whistled, and you know, it's armpit is enough. Diogo was very convinced that it's not offside, and he might know it the best. So in the end, I couldn't see it back yet, but it was no offside. And the whole bench told me already before, no, onside. So, of course, important goal in a good moment.
After the first leg, do you feel you had a little bit to prove? You knew there was an improvement here tonight?
No, we had nothing to prove. You have these two games and you have to take the result from the first game. If you lose at home 1-0, does that mean we shall not arrive at Arsenal and try it? No, of course not. So we drew at home in a for us difficult game. Said at that time, we played not 20 times together in that formation. So you end up playing against 10 men. Breaking a low block down is the most difficult thing in football. Today, we did much better, but it's just it was 11-11. Arsenal had their own ideas, and so they were not here just to defend. I think it's not possible in your own stadium. So it was clear the game will open up slightly, but we still had to score, and that's what we did.
I appreciate it's quite a few weeks away, but it'll be a first ever final, domestic final in England, with two German managers going head to head.
Sorry. When is it exactly?
End of February.
So we have a little bit of time, plenty of games to play until then. I'm pretty sure the game will not be about the two German managers, about two really good football teams. But we wanted desperately to go to that final. Now it's Chelsea. Fine. Let's give it a try.
And we spoke to Trent as well. Your last trophy you won in the depths of COVID, no supporters. It wasn't probably as you wanted it. Now you go to Wembley and hopefully, from your point of view, we'll lift silverware in front of your supporters.
Yeah, but I don't think about celebrations or whatever. When we then start preparing the game, we think about how do we have to approach the game against Chelsea. So that's it. And I'm really happy for our supporters that they have the chance to go to Wembley and hopefully celebrate something. But how is that? Between now and then, there's a lot of time to go. And I enjoyed our trophies without supporters a lot, to be honest. Because it was just so special. But yes, we all know with them it's really special. But there's a game to play before we think about celebrating.